All right, John Anik, Dominic Cruz here in Newark, New Jersey. And tonight, as many expected, belonged to Colby Covington. What an offensive performance by the former interim champ tonight.
That's exactly all you could say. Wow, I was really impressed with not just the pace that he kept, but the way that he mixed it up. And he really offset Robbie Lawler from beginning to end.
So the 2019 Fighter of the Year right now, in my mind, is Jorge Masvidal, right? Knockouts of Darren Till, and then, of course, the fastest knockout in UFC history against Ben Askren. But on the strength of this performance for Colby Covington, given what UFC President Dana White has said in the past, you would think he would be hard to deny a shot at the undisputed champ, Kamaru Usman.
It's not hard for Dana to deny title shots to anybody, let's be honest. But he will have a hard time fighting with the fans a little bit, because I feel like that's those four guys. You got Leon Edwards, Masvidal, you got Colby Covington, and Usman. You could literally put any of those guys in there,
right,
and you can't really make a mistake.
So back in March, the undisputed title changed hands. Of course, Tyron Woodley out, Kamaru Usman in. Woodley still factors prominently in this equation. Robbie Lawler now on the outside looking in with his third successive loss. You know Dana wants to make that fight between Jorge Masvidal and Leon Edwards, but has this welterweight division 1 through 6 or 8 ever been stronger than it is right now in 2019?
Yeah, I couldn't actually tell you that exactly, but I'll say that right now I would not want to be in that top 8. It would be tough. I mean, it's a tough time to be champion in that division, and, you know, Usman being at the top, that says it all. That man is very hard to beat.
So this UFC fight night on ESPN will long be remembered for what Colby Covington was able to do just in terms of the sheer volume. But the other seminal moment, Sparta, New Jersey's own. How about Jim Miller getting it done? 33rd UFC appearance. No man or woman has had more, and 5 straight fights have ended in round 1. He gets a quick finish of Clay Guida tonight.
Yeah, and how about the career he had with Lyme disease before he decided to get rid of it and now become, you know, reunited with his career again.
Yeah.
Coming back, winning in front of his kids, winning in his hometown with finishes back-to-back. He has looked incredible.
Yeah.
I mean, all these guys, this fight card right here was something that everybody used to go back and watch if you haven't seen it.
All right, so we will see how it all proceeds moving forward. The good news is we've got a title fight coming up next Saturday. You can see it live on ESPN+. Plus, Valentina Shevchenko looks to a lot of people as a champion who is going to defend this belt for some time. But this is one that she wants to get back against Liz Carmouche. They fought in 2010. Your expectations for the rematch here coming up next weekend?
Well, Liz Carmouche is in exceptional shape. I've gotten to cross train with her and some pool work and some stuff that we do in San Diego. Her cardio is insane. Her physique, the strength that she carries, the mental fortitude and focus. I mean, this is a tough fight for Shevchenko, but she's facing a Shevchenko that has looked stronger with her jiu-jitsu, her grappling, her judo than ever, and that's what Liz Carmouche brings to the table, is the grappling edge. Can Liz Carmouche stand with her? That's the question, because Shevchenko has looked phenomenal on her feet as well.
Well, you can be sure it will be a happy flight for the Shevchenkos to Uruguay after Antonina rallied after an early cut to get her first career win by submission, so congratulations to Antonina. Valentina, your move. After Shevchenko and Carmouche in Uruguay, August 17th, we return to pay-per-view UFC 241. It is the heavyweight championship rematch. Former champ Stipe Miocic trying to even this series at 1 with Daniel Cormier. Close fight according to Las Vegas. You can't even talk about this fight without smiling.
I mean, if you think about it, DC was DC at 205. We'll call him DC squared at heavyweight. How about that? He is twice the size he usually is, and he wears it well. I mean, the way he showed up in that fight against Stipe was incredible. He's hard to move. He's built, I said it before, he's built like a kettlebell. I mean, you ever tried to pick up a kettlebell and move it? You can't.
Right.
It's very hard. You got to get a grip on it. And you can't grab Daniel Cormier and take him down. He's short. He's heavy. He knows how to use his hips. But he's able to get underneath people, and he uses the upper body clinch, which is what all heavyweights, the best heavyweights in the world, Randy Couture, and so on and so forth, use that Greco-Roman wrestling, Cain Velasquez, and then they use that to drop down to the legs. This is a problem that caused a lot of issues early for Miocic. Mixed with the speed of Daniel Cormier, those things are going to be something because they're both boxer wrestlers.
All right, and finally, before I let you go, I'm not going to show you my 209 tattoo, but I cannot curb my enthusiasm for this co-headliner between Anthony Showtime Pettis and Nate Diaz. Diaz has been out since 2016, north of 1,000 days. Pettis with all this welterweight momentum right now. Your thoughts on the co-main coming up in 2 weeks?
Well, Diaz has been doing marathons and all kinds. This man is in shape, so don't think that he's not ready for these fights because he's been out for a little bit of time. If anything, his body's rested, his mind's rested, he's energized and ready to go. Anthony Pettis, on the other hand, has been on the move nonstop. He's been competing, he's been training, he looks strong, he's been lifting, he enjoys the new weight class that he's at, not depleting himself, cutting weight. So I really, really want to see this matchup because both of them have great striking. One of them's a kickboxer, one of them's more of a boxer. Southpaw versus conventional. Anthony Pettis switches stance, but more than anything, if this goes to the ground, you also have a highlight reel potential on the ground too, because both of them are phenomenal at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
All right, you can only see it on pay-per-view August 17th, UFC 241. Memorable night here in Newark, New Jersey. For Dominic Cruz, I'm John Anik. Uruguay, your move.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming and special content, subscribe to ESPN+.